Healthy cooking is a journey. You just don't wake up one day and say that, oh, I'm going to start eating all healthy and then just, you know, do some magic and the whole kitchen transforms. Healthy cooking is also that takes a lot of effort at the beginning. So the way you should start is something that I would suggest is that take it slow, transform one thing at a time, and you know, transform the one thing that you use it the most. For example, the first thing that I would actually transform in my kitchen essentials for healthy cooking is the pan. Now, pans is something that you will cook your food on daily. You will warm something up inside it or you will cook something delicious. So you have to make sure that the pan that you're using is made of the right material. So if you have been using aluminum pans, then maybe it's time for you to start there. Take it out. If you have been using non-stick pan that was like so many years old that it looks like something else, like surface of a moon cratered and like skin coming out everywhere, then it's time for you to change that pan. I've talked in great detail about pans in this video. Make sure you check it out. You will learn a lot about all the healthy options that you have. Number two, knives. Now, this is something that you will always need, right? So you don't have to use knife to scare people. You don't have to have knives that kind of keep rusting so that you are scared when you're using them. You need a good knife so that cutting vegetables or anything that you are having at home is easy. Now, there are knives for everything. If you actually go to a kitchen utensil store, you will see that they have like 100 different types of knife. And there is a knife that is there for daily use. So try to choose the knife that you will be using on a daily basis. You don't have to actually have like a knife for cutting cheese, a knife for cutting, tomato, a knife for cutting onions. The best quality knives are made of stainless steel. And the reason is that it will not rust. You will cut foods that have moisture in them. So if you are going to use knives that are not made of very good stainless steel, then it will start rusting and that's not good for you. It should also be made of material that can be sharpened again and again. Nowadays, you have professional companies that will do the sharpening of the knives for you. So these knives can last you for years. So when people ask me, how do you never cry when you're chopping onions? And how is it so much of a pleasure chopping onion? Like how is it even meditating? Use a sharp knife and it will do the trick. The faster you cut, the less the crushing force will be. You will also make great salads, especially if you are going to cut tomatoes. You know, your tomato will not look like puree in a salad. So knife is actually essential, because when I talk about healthy cooking, I also say that visually your food also needs to look good. And cutting is one of those places where you actually begin. Number three. So the best kitchen helper that you can have is somebody who can help without actually asking you too many questions. I'm talking about the blenders and food processors. And this frustrates people a lot because they go and buy that is kind of not too expensive. They end up buying a juicer when they actually needed something that can blend food of different types and consistency. Sometimes they end up buying some blender that's not powerful enough to do their job. And remember I said that cooking or your healthy cooking is a journey. Right? So if you invest in a good blender and food processor, you can always extend its abilities by the accessories that you can have on it. So when you think about a food processor and a blender, think that what can I use it for other than just blending some vegetables or some spices? I need to do something more with it. So have that in mind. Then you will get this true value for money. And you will also be able to use it for several different applications. Number four, pressure cookers. Pressure cookers have been there for a very long time, but people have some kind of a fear using them because the technology that was used maybe when your grandmother was using it was not so refined. So people are afraid that, okay, it's gonna blow up. I can't see what's cooking inside. And you think that, I wish I could actually see if the food is burning or not. Pressure cookers are of different types. One is programmable and another one is manual. And again, the manual ones, there are ones that are noisy that will actually have this weight that is attached to it and it will keep coming off to release steam and pressure. And the one which is silent, it will release the pressure slowly. Then you have programmable pressure cookers, which is something like Instapot. And there are many different brands that make it. And what's nice about that is that you can actually program it saying that, okay, I'm going to cook rice, and it will decide how much time you have to cook it for. And you can go take a shower, come back, and the food is ready. And programmable pressure cookers can be used for many different purposes. You can even make yogurt at home with it. So make sure you invest in a good pressure cooker, manual or programmable, whatever your choice is. Why I love manual pressure cooker is because I can release the steam very easily. Just put it under running water and the steam is released and I can open it. So the control is greater. You get pressure cookers of different sizes, and the liters that you have to decide on, that okay, do I need a 4-liter one, 2.5 liter one, will depend on how many people you're cooking the food for. I actually even travel with a pressure cooker. So there are these tiny pressure cookers that you get. They're also very lightweight, and I always carry it with me. In fact, when I was traveling in Indonesia with my toddler, she was really young, she was not even a toddler, she was a baby, and I made sure that the food that she gets is fresh every single morning. So I was carrying this pressure cooker with me. That was a part of my luggage. It surprised a lot of people, but I was actually very happy that I'm able to give my baby the right food every single day. So what are pressure cookers good for? Why can't a pot or a pan do the same job like a pressure cooker? Well, the best comparison I can give you is boiling chickpeas. So if you're a person who is switching into beans and legumes particularly, you might realize that cooking it in an open pot will take you about 45 minutes. But in a pressure cooker, the same job can be done in 15 minutes. So your healthy cooking journey does not mean that you have to cook for hours in the kitchen. You can do that in a very short time just by using pressure cookers. Number 6, steamers. Now, I'm not talking about the steamers that sail in the river. I'm talking about the kitchen utensil called steamer. Now, steamer is a pot which can retain water, and then there are several other perforated pots in which you can place the vegetables or any other thing that you want to cook. There is a popular misconception here that people think that steamers are not so essential because the only thing they do is steam vegetables. But you can do several things with it. You can steam sprouts, you can steam grains, you can also reheat the food using steamers. And steamers also do the job very quickly. In fact, you get this multi-layered steamers in which you can cook the entire meal in one go. So this is one of the best things that you can actually invest in as you move in the progression of your healthy cooking journey. A lot of people think that healthy cooking is all about using healthy ingredients. But I must say, actually insist that if you are somebody who is obsessed with healthy cooking in a way that you spend hours in the kitchen, then it's not healthy for you. You know, you are missing out on exercise. You're missing out on your relationship time that you have with your friends or with your partner. So make sure you keep the time you spend in the kitchen as little as possible. And one of the best ways to do that is to use pressure cooker and steamers. So this is a kitchen essential, I would say, not just for healthy cooking, but for any type of cooking. So when you visit our website, happybellyfish.com, you will find there Healthy Cooking Bootcamp, where we have shared recipes and methods to use pressure cookers and steamers in your daily cooking. So you will love actually exploring this. So make sure you check that out. Number 7, mandolin and spiralizer. So there is, I think, a music instrument which is also called mandolin. I'm not talking about that. This is the one that makes this very fine slices of vegetables, and this is a great tool. It's dangerous, of course. You need to be very careful when you're using them. You also get gloves which will prevent your hand from getting severe cuts. I actually had an accident, and after that I started using this gloves to protect my hand. But what I like about using mandolins and spiralizer is that it makes my food look delicious. It's essential to actually make your food look great. You don't just eat with your mouth, you eat with your nose. You want to make sure that the food smells nice. You want to make sure that, you know, the food looks nice. You eat through your eyes. So it will give you a healthy appetite. So apart from the fact that I always say that make sure you serve your food nicely, you also should make sure that your food is cut nicely. These are easy to maintain and store. They do not take a lot of space in your kitchen. This is something that you do not need immediately. But as you move on in your healthy cooking journey, when you want your food to suddenly start looking very nice, Instagrammable, this is the thing that you need. Number 8, measuring cups. Now, why measuring cups and what do you want to measure with it? Let's say you're following a recipe, right? And they say use 1 cup of this and 1 cup of that. And the measurement that they have is so precise because they will also say how much spice you have to use for a particular type of recipe. And this is where measuring cups will be very helpful for you. So your experience after cooking will not be so frustrating. Why doesn't it look so good like it looks in the picture of the recipe book? So this is something that you need to make sure that you have. These are also very inexpensive. And another great thing I like about having measuring cups is because I can know how much food I'm actually eating. If you are on a particular journey, let's say you want to lose weight or you want to gain weight, you will know how to portion your food. It should not be that, you know, you cooked and it turned out to be more than you wanted to or less. If you have more, you will have leftovers. And if you keep on piling these leftovers, it can be a very frustrating experience. And then number 9, we are very close, guys. And trust me, this is something that's extremely important because it will also link you to the other aspect of healthy cooking, meal planning. Now, food containers is what I'm talking about here. So if you are cooking something and you do not have a place to store, you will start putting it in your cups and bowls that you have and your fridge will kind of look like a giant mess. You will also not be able to see what is where. Then that can be a very frustrating experience. So if you want to store the food nicely, then I would recommend 2 things here. You can buy this glassware that you can store the food in, or you can also reuse the glass jars that you can buy from a shop. And the last one, number 10, Dutch ovens. Now, what are Dutch ovens? Now, this is an enameled cast iron pot or a pan, and also it comes with a lid, and that's the crucial part. What I like about Dutch oven is that you can use it for several purposes. In fact, as you keep on learning different things in your cooking journey, you might come to a stage where you might say that I want to make my own bread. And the nice thing about this pot is that you can use it as a cast. You don't have to go and buy something else now, you know, to just start making your bread. You can also make one pot meals here. Let's say you come to that stage where you want to cook really quick and something really delicious. Then you can use it to make your casseroles, your soups, you know, the things that you can do with this Dutch oven is limitless. Yes, it's a little pricey, but like I said, you don't have to do everything in one go. So all these kitchen utensils and essentials that I'm talking about, I've left a link for all of them in the description below. Do check them out and make sure you subscribe to our channel so that you get notified when we publish a new video or new recipes.